Antiquarks are the opposites of quarks, which are the building blocks of protons and neutrons. These subatomic particles have been studied extensively over the years and are believed to be important in understanding the nature of the universe. Let's start by discussing the basics of antiquarks. Antiquarks are fundamentally the same as quarks, but with opposite charge and spin. Antiquarks are typically produced in high-energy particle collisions or through natural processes such as radioactive decay. In particle collisions, high-energy particles are accelerated and then made to collide with a target material. When these particles collide, they can produce new particles, including quarks and antiquarks. Scientists at the Large Hadron Collider in Switzerland have been able to produce antiquarks by colliding protons at high speeds. In radioactive decay, an unstable atomic nucleus undergoes a spontaneous transformation, emitting particles and energy in the process. One common type of radioactive decay is beta decay, which involves the transformation of a neutron in the nucleus into a proton and an electron. During this process, an antiquark is also produced. The existence of antiquarks was first proposed by Murray Gell-Mann and George Zweig in the early 1960s as part of their quark model, which postulated that protons and neutrons are made up of quarks. This model was later confirmed by experiments, and since then, scientists have been studying the properties of antiquarks in more detail. Antiquarks also play an important role in the strong force because they are one of the two types of particles, the other being quarks, that make up the protons and neutrons in the nucleus of an atom. The strong force is the force that holds these particles together. Antiquarks contribute to the strong force in a unique way because they have the opposite electric charge of their corresponding quarks. This means that when an antiquark comes in contact with a quark, they can cancel out each other's charge, making it easier for the strong force to hold them together. So that was antiquarks in a nutshell. I hope you found the video informative and interesting. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.